Councillor Green, Councillor Lane, you formally move to amendments.
Formally seconded, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Okay, it is open for debate. I hope you're on from that way inclined, but if people want to speak, we will take their names. I will try to keep a political balance, but that does mean people have to stand up. So, okay, Councillor Elderton, take you first.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. I'm always very wary of any organisation that scrutinises its own decision-making processes. We've had some appalling examples in the last few years, particularly associated with the police of Hillsborough. A lot of other associated ideas where the police have decided to scrutinise themselves have not made a very good job of it and have had to be called to account in a major way. My own belief is that it looks bad to the community if we end up with the decision-making arm of the council actually being the same party that scrutinises those decisions. I don't think it's in the part of political matter, I think it's a matter of natural justice. We all know we've been through an appalling few years when we've been accused, all of us, at different levels, of running the council in a poor way. We've had the government, we've had the change of officers, we've had all the advice recommendations made to us, including the fact that we should be more open and we should make decisions, scrutinise their decisions and do them properly, scrutinise their decisions and make sure this is done properly in the interest of the people who we serve on Wirral. So I think if we leave this as being a situation where the ruling administration does scrutinise its own decisions, we have still got a major elephant in the room and the public are not going to like it. They're going to say, oh, here we go again. We're going to go back to the old days where all decisions were made correctly, and they weren't challenged properly because nobody had the wit or the will to do so on any side. So it is a very genuine concern. I'm not making a political point, I'm making a point in terms of how the public sees us. After all the problems we've had, all the media challenge we've had, but the way we run our business. And I do believe that scrutiny must always be chaired by members of the, other than the party who makes the executive decision. And apply that to any circumstances, whether it's the police or whether it's the health service, whether it's the NHS, all these problems that occurred in the NHS recently. They all had a major fault trying to resolve them, but they all had the major defect in that process that they were being scrutinised by their people. Now, nobody believes scrutiny carried out by the same organisation as gave the instruction in the first place. It's just something that is alien to the natural perception of things. So I do believe the decision shouldn't be subject to a whip of any sort, because it isn't a matter of what we should be whipping on. We should be thinking of the benefits that would accrue to the members of the public that we serve, that we're elected to serve, if they see that we are totally transparent, objective and thorough in the way we scrutinise all the decisions that are made. I would be the first one to say that a lot of the decisions made by the Cabinet have been good. Some of them have been bad, very bad, and we've challenged them when they have been. But I'm not entirely happy with the way the scrutiny process has been able to challenge their bad decisions and to put something right as a result of it. So that's really my fear. We're going to walk down back at a retrograde step into where we were a few years ago. And the last one we want to start, I believe we have a responsibility to the public we serve to make sure that not only we do things right, but we're seen to do things right, and we challenge incorrect decisions where they appear to affect the people that we serve. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Elderton, Councillor Clements, and Councillor Stuart Kelly next. Councillor Boyle Bobbitt, and Councillor Mike Sorbitt. And then, if everyone agrees, we'll go to seconds. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Having served on the promise gateway which allows children to be found supported.
Well, this is a bizarre decision by the Eden Council. Indeed, we've had a preview, possibly, of Councillor Davis's response to this debate in the pages of the Echo this morning and online on the Globe website. His reason, apparently, for removing opposition councillors from chairing the scrutiny committees is that the behaviour of the opposition parties last year was totally irresponsible. And we don't feel they deserve to be in a position of responsibility. I was amazed to read that as a justification. And having read it, I decided to have a look back at what the scrutiny committees have been doing these last 12 months. I believe it finds so irresponsible. I looked at the Transformation and Resources Committee. They did a scrutiny review dealing with freedom of information. Well, I can understand why this administration would have would consider that sort of review to be irresponsible, considering their record on secrecy. I found that the Regeneration and Environment Committee were looking at car parking charges and apprenticeships. Scandalous committee. I didn't even notice it. And finally, the Families and Wellbeing Committee were looking at the implications of the Francis Review for Wirral. They were looking at care home standards. They were looking at services for adapted children. Now, if the leader of the council thinks that is irresponsible, then he is wrong. And I hope that he will correct the slur that is reported in the press. Councillor Davis also refers to his stunning victory in the local elections of justification. I was reminding that Glazed received some 38% of the popular votes during those elections, and even in terms of numbers, not an awful lot has altered in the balance of this council. Maybe something has changed which has clearly irked the Labour leader and potentially the Labour group sufficient to lash out and to attempt to get, if you like, vengeance on the electors of the board. In his quote in the newspaper, Mr. Mayor criticises me for daring to criticise him. Or Mr. Mayor, when they try to ask schools to pay to use their pupil premium to pay for school closet patrols, when they switch off streetlights against the advice of police, and when they've been flagged to be uncollected for weeks on end, they deserve to be criticised and they deserve to be scrutinised.
Members or however number there are on the committee do need to make themselves available to take part in that work rather than just
I saw them, and then we will move to seconds.
Thanks, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, on the chairs of the committees, the parties just have engaged last year. I tried to go to all the training I could go to, all the meetings on the future of the council, and there was very few of the opposition. I mean, I'm talking about the Tories now, because there are that few of the Lib Dems, whether they turn up or not, if they but particularly on the futures of the council and the training, you just fail to engage. So, but unless I've missed something, on the committees, we haven't cut the numbers on the committees. I mean, we've got people from the two parties opposite to me who will be on the committees. We are open and transparent. The committees will be run and the opposition can have their say, as well as our members. And I, for one, will scrutinise as much as I possibly can our executive, and I hope the parties opposite will do the same. But the party political points Stuart Kelly made, you know, well, we expect that of Stuart Kelly. He'll probably be in the World Globe tomorrow, and he's got his own column. We expect that. But please, I'm talking now to the opposition. Engage with us, scrutinise, hold the executive to account. I know my colleagues here on this side of the chamber will. So please go along with us and stop making the cheap party political points. We are trying to run the council. We've had savage cuts, and we're trying to do our best. No, that's it, Stuart. We have had savage cuts. Jeff even acknowledged that when he spoke about the cuts. But we are trying to do our best, but engage with us. And also, on finishing, I'd like to pay tribute to Harry. He was much maligned last year about the potholes. He put words in his mouth that he never said. He did do a magnificent job for this council for a long, long time. So the cheap jibes, you know, we can expect nothing less from the Tories. So I would like to pay tribute to Harry and the stand that really where he did. But engage with us. Engage. Thanks. Yeah.
Was this not a sincere trip? with what was happening. And clearly, I hoped, as we all did, that Wirral Borough Council, as a result of their intervention, had actually changed. I'm afraid that doesn't appear to be the case here today. So really, was it just all window dressing on behalf of the leader of the council? You know, have the LGA really been duped? And I have to say, if this is an example of how Wirral Borough Council is purporting to move forward, then clearly perhaps we have all been duped. Democracy really should be alive and well in Wirral. It certainly isn't. It's not only extremely sick, it's actually dead as far as I'm concerned. Because, Phil, I would have really expected more from yourself. Probably you've got a lot of hungry mouths to feed now because you are a large group and you're trying to appease everybody. Any leader cannot appease everybody. And certainly, I find that when many years ago now, when the two committees of, as it was then, education and social services were completely split under a time I did chair the social services committee, the agenda on that was huge. It was massive, it was time consuming, and all members fully engaged with it, and I'm sure it was the same on the old education committee. But clearly, to put all those responsibilities together, when let's face it, Wirral doesn't have a good record on actually making sure that vulnerable older people have been safeguarded. We won't go into that particular issue tonight, but we don't have a good record. This really is a backward step, and I am rather ashamed really to have to say that we have to discuss this tonight within this council chamber, because I, for one, putting cynicism aside, really thought this council had changed. Unfortunately, it doesn't look as if it has. And really, you know, Harry's number one fan over there for Councillor Sullivan to start lecturing us on how we should be behaving, how we should be engaging. Perhaps he'd just like to have a look at some of the training records of members of this particular group who clearly he's referring to, on some of the outside bodies that we serve on, because I think you'd be pleasantly surprised, because we all admit that we have things to learn, and we probably do that learning in a far better place than here.
Absolutely condemned.